as you can see right behind me here, we have a yearly look that we have on the show. These are tulips. These are daffodils. Lady in the audience had me really concerned for a moment, because every year we are sent by the Washington State Daffodil Festival in Puyallup, Washington. I love that name, Puyallup. And they send us these beautiful daffodils.
Of course.
Why did you think they were tulips?
Well, they haven't opened up totally, that's what I meant.
They haven't? Open up! You're the star of a show, you can sometimes they will open up like that. When will they open up?
9 o'clock.
What are you talking about? I guess we can get a week out of these?
Sure.
Okay. Daffodils from Puyallup. Okay. Tonight we have Gene Siskel and Roger Ebert will be out to discuss, I guess, probably motion pictures and the Oscars. We have Connie Chung. And we have a young singer by the name of Judy Rodman. Did you watch the Oscars last night?
I was at a party, so I couldn't really see them as well.
a little noisy, was it?
Yeah.
Anyway, we're going to get their views on the show. I'm getting a little over-Oscared, you know.
Yeah.
Just going to wrap it up tonight. You know, there are only 20 major categories in the Academy Awards, but somehow those 20 categories stretch out every year. And having done the show, last night it was 3 hours and 25 minutes.
Yeah.
And I was the host one year. We used to have a bet with the crew how long the show would run. It was like a lottery, you know, you get the last. And I had 3 hours and 38 minutes. And when it got to 3 hours and 38 minutes, I was just going to go out and say goodnight, and I would have won the
money.
I went 3 hours and 42 minutes. It's way too long. Mostly when people get up, they thank usually the people who produce the picture, their agent, then they get carried away, and they start to mention people nobody knows. They usually refer to them as the people behind the scenes, the little people. And if it weren't for the little people behind the scenes on this show, and we have actually some very little people. You've heard that, you know?
Yeah.
Who are these people? Have you ever met any of the little people behind the scenes?
I don't believe I have.
Well, they're the ones, that do all this work behind there. Their contributions are vital. Tonight we'd like to pay tribute to some of these faceless, nameless, tireless people behind the scenes. You're not buying this. for example, do you know the name Stan Ostrobasket?
No.
Of course you don't. He's one of those little people. He worked on Alfred Hitchcock's classic, The Birds. Now, his work doesn't show in the final film, but he spent a month and a half before shooting, diapering 4,800 crows. As I did that, I had a frog in my throat, otherwise that would have been dynamite. In Rambo First Blood Part 2, Sylvester Stallone came down with laryngitis one day, and Tony Danza had to be brought in as a stunt grunt. Remember the chariot race in Ben-Hur? Of course you do.
Of course.
You don't even have to say yes, or I'll just go like this. It was counterfeiter Mario Riccardi who provided phony green cards for the valet parking attendants in Ben-Hur.
They're getting restless.
I'm in it again. Didn't we go through this last week? I had a piece here that started off about like this.
And then went downhill?
Well, no. Let's try this. The Exorcist. Regis Patouille, a name you don't see on the credits, is the guy who worked the crank on Linda Blair's head. You also had to run around the room constantly with her cue cards. Very difficult. They filmed, of course, Lawrence Arabia was filmed in the desert, and it gets viciously hot out there. Peter O'Toole's brother worked on that picture, and he installed in each camel a pair of cardboard hump sunglasses that you never read about. Oh, God. I may join Oral by the program. Somebody spoke to me and said if I didn't get laughs on this tonight, I would be called home also. Let's quickly just go through this. Special effects expert Hans Klampmeyer worked on the movie Superman, super first one. And because Lois Lane sometimes got airsick while riding on the Man of Steel's back, Hans Scotch guarded his cape. Get it all out of your system. This is good for you. It's a good catharsis. Cutting some of these. In Platoon, I'm going on. In Platoon, it was Jord Kertel, the sound editor, who convinced the director that the film would be taken more seriously without the laugh track. For the color of money, Ed McMahon donated his St. Patrick's Day shorts as the pool table cover. They write cruel.
That's right.
For the fly, Willie Nelson provided his beard, which was used as the fly's dressing room. I have one more. You know, I'm inclined to agree with you folks. In The Wizard of Oz, hardware store employee Emil Beaverman squirted Rust-Oleum on the Tin Man's ankles, protecting from Toto. Did you know that? News people do this all the time.
I understand. Yes.
And that's all the news for tonight.
What are your plans for that?
We'd like to welcome under better conditions, but they're here tonight. Dunlop Tire, the tire that unleashes the legend in you.